What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today is a big day because we are installing a big brake kit on the C5 Corvette. The stock C5 brakes are going bye-bye. And here's what we're installing. This is a C6 Z06 brake kit. So we got factory OEM rotors, calipers. We got some stainless steel brake lines, and we got some ceramic brake pads. Now, I think this is going to be a multi-video series, probably 2 to 3 videos to do this whole project. I just want to break it up because otherwise this video is going to be an hour long. I want to do a comprehensive step-by-step on how to do this. There's a couple of people that have done it on YouTube, but none of them have really done a proper how-to video showing all of the steps. So I want to do that for you guys. This is going to be a proper how-to step-by-step video on how to remove your old brakes and install this new brake kit. If you guys are wondering, all of the part numbers for all of this stuff, I'm going to put in the video description below the video. So go scroll down just below the video, check out the video description, and all of this information will be down there. Now, I did purchase the calipers and the rotors and the brake pads from Rock Auto, and I purchased the stainless steel brake lines from another company. And there's also some pins that go in the calipers themselves that, for whatever reason, Rock Auto didn't have. So I had to source those elsewhere as well. All that information is going to be down below. But if you guys are curious, Rock Auto is by far the cheapest place on the internet to buy all of this stuff, without a doubt. I think all in all together, came in around $1,700. I'll put all that information down below as well. I've got it all on a spreadsheet, make it real easy for you guys. But $1,700 may sound like a lot, but when you compare it to a similar sized brake kit from, let's say, Wilwood or Brembo, you're looking at $5,000 to $8,000 for those kits. So this is definitely a bargain. So in today's video, part one, I'm going to show you how to remove your stock C5 brakes. And that is going to be the rotor and the caliper bracket. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to start at the front brake, rotor, and caliper. And since we're removing the calipers completely and replacing them, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the brake line back here. And right here, there is a 13 millimeter bolt that we're going to have to pull that off, and the brake line will just fall to the side. All right, so as you can see, we are leaking some brake fluid. Obviously, you're going to leak some brake fluid because there is fluid in the caliper and in the line right there. But not to worry, we're going to do a full brake bleed once all of this is said and done anyways, so doesn't matter. But do make sure you have a towel or some kind of container on the floor to catch all of that so you don't make a mess. All right, now we're going to remove the bracket bolts up here so the caliper can be removed from the caliper bracket. So right here, you're going to need a 15 millimeter socket. And then right here, what I believe is a 16 millimeter. You're going to need a wrench there. My wrenches go from 15 to 17, so I'm just gonna use an adjustable wrench on this. I know some of you guys shared some hate on me last time I used an adjustable wrench, but honestly, you use what you got, so. That's what I'm gonna use. So here we go. We're gonna go ahead and loosen up this bolt here. All right, now I forgot to mention there is one on the bottom here too. So one on top, one on bottom. They both work the same way. Loosen those both up. Once you break them loose, you can loosen them by hand. go ahead and take the bolt out just like that. And now you should be able to just pull that whole caliper right off. And go ahead and set that to the side. Now we just got the caliper bracket to take off. Now, if you are still using the stock brakes and you need to do a brake pad change, this is where you would be able to pull the brake pads out. Obviously, you wouldn't disconnect the brake lines, but you would still pull the caliper off all the same. Now, here is your brake pad. You're just gonna go ahead and grab it and slide it out just like that. There's one on the front and one on the back, just like that. And that's it. So you just slap your new brake pads in, put your caliper back on, tighten it up, and you're good to go. All right, now to get this caliper bracket off, there are two bolts on the back side of the spindle here that hold this caliper bracket on. And those are gonna be 21 millimeters. So you're gonna get your 21 millimeter wrench, put it on these big dudes, break them loose and get it off. All right, bolts are out. So caliper bracket just comes off just like that. We're gonna throw that to the side and we're done for that. Now we are going to be reusing these bolts for the spindle here up top. So don't be throwing these away. The new C6-06 calipers bolt up directly to the C5 spindle and we're gonna reuse these bolts here. I'll probably clean it up, make it look nice, and we'll throw some Loctite on that later. But for now we just need to take this rotor off. And I believe if you come over here, it should just pull straight off, just like that. Now, I do have this little plastic little retainer thing that kind of holds it on there. You can use this, you don't have to use it. They're kind of nice though, so I would recommend it. So now we're done. Now we got our spindle all exposed. You can see what it looks like. So that is the front. All right, so now we're gonna move to the back. And it's a similar process, except accessibility is a little bit less since obviously the front, you can turn the steering wheel and you can reach it. Rear, unfortunately, you gotta reach around the back side. So let's get to it. All right, so here's the back of the caliper. And it's gonna be the same process. First, we're going to remove the brake line right here, which goes to a 13 millimeter nut right here. So we gotta remove that first. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, now we gotta remove the caliper from the caliper bracket. Again, it's the same size as the front. We're gonna use the 15 millimeter ratchet on the bolt in the back, and then you're gonna use your wrench on the other side to hold that. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, just like that. Pull out both bolts, and there's your caliper right there. Set that off to the side. Again, now we got to take this caliper bracket off. Also, don't forget to pull out your brake pads, both sides. Watch out for flying brake pads. All right. All right, let's go ahead and get this caliper bracket off. I believe it's the same size. Let's just verify that. Yep, 21 millimeter top and bottom too. So let's get after it. Those guys were on there tight. I had to use the impact gun to get them off. When we put the new ones on, I'll be sure to give you guys the proper torque specs for everything, so no need to worry. Now that the caliper's off, you go ahead and pull your rotor off. There you go. there we go. You got the front and rear off. And now is also a good time to adjust your emergency brake right here. I'm gonna do a video on how to do that as well. So stay tuned for that. Just for fun, look at the size difference between these rear single piston and the new four piston. Just absolutely insane. And here's the front, the old two piston versus the new six piston. This is going to be a major upgrade. I'm really excited to do this. And I'm going to end part one of this series right here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. That's how you remove your stock C5 brakes. The next video will be how to install the C6Z06 brakes. So stay tuned for that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.